So in today's video, we are talking about Westin. So Westin has just finished 25 years, and on September, I guess, 11th, probably? Okay, September 3rd, they had just an anniversary, you know, finishing 25 years. So the reason I'm making this video to discuss about what are, how the credibility has been about Westin and why I feel like Westin is my favorite city, and it has not been changed their credibility since years. And in 2022 also, what things are coming up as new developments, or you know, what cities are offering in Westin, that's what we are going to discuss in this video. So before we start with the new development and stuff, let's talk about a little bit of history of this beautiful city. So this is developed in 1950s by a gentleman called Arthur Winning Davis. This was like 15,000 acre land development area they started with. Original owner and developer of Westin is called Arvida. And this development was originally named as Indian Tress. So in 1978, the first development started, and it was started around 25,000 dwelling units, and that has been reduced that time. That's not even started with 25,000 originally, started around 17,000 like residential units. So this was considered small unincorporated area of Broward County for almost a couple of years until 1995. So 1995, that's when, you know, the small committee of who were leading this unincorporated world, you know, named as Indian Tress, which was later on converted the name as Westin. That was like they proposed, like, should we make this as a city or should we just run this as unincorporated? And later on, they decided to go to 1996, filing the proposal in Broward County, considering as a city in 1997, that's what officially started. And going back to history, it started around 5,000 population initially in that 1978 it started, but around 1982 or something, that around that range, that's what it started around, living 5,000 population. In 1997, it was around 22,949, which was the original population started when it's considered as a city. And it's been, this city has been very unique because it has a great reputation in this 25 years. There was, the lines were written in 1998 when there was a first annual performance report came in. Since it was founded, Westin has continually strived to be the premier place to live, work, and raise family. Westin was conceived as a master planned community of the finest neighborhoods, and that's true even today. Service and commercial areas surrounded by best Florida's natural landscape. That's true. It is, feels like nature when you are in Westin. This vision has been realized, and today Westin is the envy of its neighbors. Strong, supportive leaders are key to West City's success. And that is true. And there are a couple of more lines there. Practical control decisions, comprehensive planning, and active public involvement create an atmosphere dedicated to building a core community. These leaders and core concept and fundamental to our development and essential to our community as we grow and reach the heights that the Westin has every ability to achieve. Yes, Westin has a really strong support system in city, and you know, they have a really, really good political involvement of improving city. They spend really good amount of money to, you know, every year make it better. And this report was written in 1998, the same again introduced in a 10th annual report, and it still today these words are true, and that's what they listed on their website when they wished Westin neighbors happy 25th anniversary. And it is a proud thing because many city have seen, you know, as time goes, they degrade sometimes and the city is not involved so much. They don't spend time. They do take money from the taxpayers, but they do not spend money as much as should be. And that's where the city reputation or city, you know, things go in go down. And many factors are important when this kind of reports comes out. For example, how is the recreational there? What, how many parks? How they upgrade themselves? Their roads, like the recreation outdoors, because Florida has very amazing weather, 365 days. People enjoy a lot outdoors. And that's what really important in every city, like any city you live in, if you guys like relocating new to Florida, or even though you're living here and deciding to go to the next city, make sure you take in this consideration outdoors or feel about that city is very, very important here. Because technically South Florida is getting a little bit overcrowded. Yes, that's true. Like last year, in 2021, we had so much relocation happen, and look at it in the news. But see, this not in just in a COVID time, but South Florida has been famous among a lot of people, not only just locals or not only people who have got the new job here, but it's been famous also for in a snowbirds or international clients. You know, they have investment properties here. So lot of factors are there why the South Florida has been really, really, really famous state, or, you know, they have a lot of cities which kind of famous for relocation clients. So any city has like this kind of like a recreation school system. That's also very important, because what kind of school system that city has or what kind of gradings it has, that's very important. And staying to the A+ grading is very difficult unless city is really giving that involvement or maintaining that culture around, then only it's possible. For example, Coral Springs, I heard from my neighbor, he's here since last 21 years. When they moved in, our next, my neighbor school, which falls in my zip code, is like Terravala. They had so much nice ratings that time. People were like, they really wanted to kind of study there. And eventually the culture got a little disturbed. Right now, there's so much drug issues going on there. Even though our neighborhood is amazing, but I'm not so happy with the school ratings where I'm living in. So that's kind of came slowly, you know, the Coral Springs has been very famous city, but still the slowly the ratings started reducing, and there's still some of the zip code has a good ratings, don't take me wrong, but still like that happens, you know. But Weston has been one of the unique city, even though it's 25 years old, it's really, really old city, still the ratings has been amazing even today. And almost all schools has amazing culture, even very family friendly culture. Like I've heard the stories, like, you know, kids goes in shopping areas and they meet teachers and they're so friendly. They're like friends, family friends. And it's really welcoming for anybody who is moving from some other states and you want some friendly environment, then Weston has that. And it has been like that since years. And that's why you see the growth of population I've listed here all these years from 1997 to 2021. That's like 71,000 something, like. So 2001 is 71,185. Wow. It really progressed really good. And still people are preferring to live in Weston. It's still not overcrowded compared to some other cities. So definitely, you are moving, then this is the time to move. There will be some time where it will be overcrowded, but still city has maintained that, you know, zoning, like their zoning is very strict. They don't put commercial buildings everywhere. Their infrastructure is so amazing. 2 to 3 mile radius, you will find parks, you will find the recreational areas. There are almost like a 14 parks in Weston, and all has been so amazing. City has been putting money there. They do have a plans in 2022 where they are resurfacing their tennis court areas in a Tucosta Tris Park, Racquet Club, court lighting has been getting upgraded, the landscaping getting upgraded. They keep adding new trees. They believe, like a city believes in nature, and they want to preserve that nature feel. There are almost like 35,000 to 38,000 trees, palm trees there. And there are some of the nature trees also is there. It's very mandatory, like HOA system there. So you cannot, you know, do anything you want in community because they want to maintain the standard, and that's pretty good to maintain the culture. You can't cut trees, if you want to kind of add trees, you have to take a couple of like permissions from, not from the city, just only not from the city, but also from homeowner associations. They have been really good management system invest in. And overall, also maintenance, if you see, the city does amazing job. Anywhere you go, golf courses are very well maintained. You will not see outdated things there. Weed cleanings and even on the broadwalks, like, has been so nice. Like bike trails, they are also in 2022, they're adding some of the more bike trails. They are making more safer for bikers. There are accidents happens here because, you know, many people like enjoy outdoors having in this beautiful weather. So you will see a lot of bikers around even with small kids. So Weston is one of the very unique city where almost anywhere you go, you have a bike trails. And that's where they keep improving, you know, making it more safer for bikers. You will also see like marathons happening, city events happening, like in Halloween, there are like so many different kinds of events. Like if you see just on a Facebook or Google, oh my God, so many events to choose from. So you will not go bored anywhere. Like you don't even have to leave a city to go to some other city to enjoy. Like Alan Crosby has not been so effective in organizing events. They are doing some of the developments, honestly, like in a city council, city building, I hope, you know, they start doing some of the events. But overall, it's been not so good. I sometimes go, to Weston just to enjoy those events with my daughter. So that's very, very, something if you're looking for your young kids, then you will definitely enjoy. So as you see, that reputation has been so nice this 25 years, and the future also is very bright. So, you know, and also like there are some new constructions there. Like if you go in a Botanico, there's a new construction there. If you're looking to buy something really new built. However, the houses there are not too old also. They are not like built in 1960s. Like if you go in Fort Lauderdale, oh my God, they're built in 1950s, 1960s. Many people right now buying those old ones and vanishing from the bottom and making new ones because they're not new ones there. Like you won't even find 1990s houses there. So in Weston, you know, in reverse, you many communities you will see like 2000 plus built. So you will have a choice to kind of buy something. And as long as, you know, the construction is good, the roof is good, inside you can do remodeling. It's not a big deal to do remodeling. Like I do flipping, you know, for my like 40% of my business, I invest in flipping. I work with a lot of investors and doing this remodeling. I know one time, two times you are doing, that's a little bit crazy for you guys. But when I'm doing this every day for my living, it's not too crazy. Trust me. If you have a good people around, if you have a good team, it's not too crazy. And you will get what you need to do. You build up the even equity. So again, real estate is a numbers game. So if you have a good team, you have a good professionals around, you will not go wrong if you are buying investment, even though you want something newer built. So that's it. I mean, I guess we discussed a lot of good information here. If you need more information or if you need to talk to 101, then also we're available for no pressure consultation. So I usually do the Zoom call, so it's easier to share screen and talk to people, talk to you and kind of go over the details. Every person's situation is unique. Most of the time, as long as your distance is okay for your work, Weston will definitely work for you. So if you have still more questions, there are some other videos too. Try to check out those videos, pros and cons. There are some of the negative things also I talk about there. But those negative things are not so bad, it's not so bad that overcomes the good factors. So good factors are really nice there. So trust me, you will not go wrong in living in Weston.